What is up, guys? Welcome to the AO Fuzzy podcast, the number one podcast in its category. You already know what it is. I'm gonna speak it into existence, even though I might be lying right there, but it's okay because it's gonna happen. I'm gonna tell you right now, we're gonna get that number one spot back again. Thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting the podcast online. I see the likes, I see the algorithm. I see it all. But welcome into the podcast because it is my podcast and not yours. Like I said before, I help you be better through the faults of others. You're welcome. Today we have an amazing guest from the Kit community, an amazing BIPOC streamer. They are absolutely the coolest auntie that I have seen on Kit thus far. Maybe you know who they are. It is Shakaababyy. We will get to them in 1 second. But first, I gotta pay my motherfucking light bill, guys. Today's sponsor is Glitch Energy. Go to glitchenergy.com, use D4RKFUZZY at checkout for an amazing discount. Again, thank y'all for being here. We're going to hit you off with the song of the day right here. You already know what it is, guys. You know how we roll. Enjoy it. I will see you guys in a couple seconds right after this song.
Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen. This is a Jazzy Fizzle production.
Funky fresh, with my body so melodic, this beat rolls right through my chest. Everybody, Martin, Poppy came to party. Grab somebody, work your body. Let me see you 1, 2 step. Rock it, don't stop it. Everybody, get on the floor. Bring the party up, we about to get it on. Let me see you 1, 2 step. I love it when you 1, 2 step. Everybody, 1, 2 step.
This beat is
outrageous, so contagious, make you crave it.
Jazzy made it.
So retarded, top charted, ever since the day I started. Strut my stuff and yes, I flaunt it. Goodies make the boys jump on it. No.
That is the song of the day. Thank y'all again for being here. I have an amazing guest. Shakaababyy, tell them who you are. Say hello.
I mean, what's goody? I'm here. Okay, so yeah, so I'm Shakaababyy, you know, Shaka Zulu, Shaka the Zoo, Daddy, depending on who you asking. That's me. I go by they, them pronouns. I am from New York. I have been streaming for 3 years now, originally started on Facebook and have now made my way to Kick. The number one platform. I said what I said, and I do a little bit of everything. I like to just chat. I like to game. I have now coined myself and been confirmed as the number one crocheter on the platform because that is what I do. And yeah, I like to spread positivity. I like to just spread as much love as I can and just allow people to feel loved and welcomed and acknowledged and as seen as I can.
And that's what's up. That is 100% what's up. That's the reason why I have you here.
Thank you.
Like I said, for those that you do not know, Shaka, unfortunately, I was having a bad day that day. I'm not going to lie. I was having a very bad day. I had woken up. I was pissed at the world. You know, stubbed my toe. Fell down the stairs that day. Spilled coffee on myself. And when I came in to Shaka's chat, I just want to let you know right now, the most loving, the most funniest, and the most realest person I've pretty much seen on the app so far, that kept it 100, just said, "Hey, Fuzz, how you doing? How you having? Hope you're having a good day." And I was talking about how I would like to sew. And Shaka was like, "Hey, I can't do that." And I was like, "How can you not sew when you just made this beautiful-ass jacket that I could never make?" I'm going to tell you that right now. I could never make that. I could try.
You can. You can, I got you, but yeah, I can't sew for nothing. I can't sew.
I can build a dress, I could build some pants, I could do anything you want with that, with sewing, but the needle point. Can do it. It does not compute with my brain.
I understand.
But basically what I'm getting at, guys, is I like to put people on the platform here and give them a voice. It's different than having to be 100% on camera. when you're on camera, sometimes people are different. Shaka, not different. Same person on camera, just like me, is the same person you're going to see on Discord, same person you're going to see in real life. We did want to talk about a couple little things before we get into these nitty-gritty questions. I always have an icebreaker question that I like to do. It may be funny, it may be stupid, but I always like to ask it, okay? And this is the icebreaker question for you. If you could wear one style of underwear for the rest of your life, what style of underwear would it be?
Boxers.
Period. Me, it would be boxer briefs because, I need support.
I like the flowiness. Give me the boxes. I'm good.
Get you the boxes. Did want to talk about a amazing thing that you have coming up. I don't know if you want to let the people know what it is.
You, by all means, take the lead, baby. Go ahead. Tell them.
So there is Shaka's going to be doing a crochet class, okay? A knitting class. And teaching you guys how to do it. I'm going to try. The key word here, y'all, is try. All right? Today is the try. But they don't have to do that, okay? They do not have to do any of that for the community. They don't have to teach anybody, but they're wanting to do that and give back. That's what it is about. It's not that hard. I know I'm probably, spicing it up a little bit, saying I can't do it. I know I could probably do it. But come check it out. Go over to Twitter if you guys want to. There is a list of everything that you can get. I'm still missing a couple things because my dollar store looks like the demonic plague hit it.
Mm-hmm. They usually do.
It looks like World War V in my dollar store. I went to Joann's to try to find the right size thread, and I couldn't find it because they didn't have it. So hopefully I can find some good yarn. It's not thread. See, I'm thinking about sewing and making clothes. It's yarn. But we're going to get right into the questions here. Where did you grow up?
So, as I said, I'm a New Yorker, and depending on whatever New Yorker you ask, they gonna say that I'm valid or I'm not valid, but I am from Long Island. I was born here. I was raised here. I still live here. So Long Island proud. I stand by that. And I don't always tell people where exactly my hometown is, but because I still am a local. But I do let people know that I grew up in a very multicultural town here on Long Island. I'm very proud of that. I'm very proud of the fact that it was so diverse. It still is to this day very diverse, if not more than what it used to be. And it allowed for me to have exposure to just so many different ethnic backgrounds with languages and cultures and anything and everything that comes out of that in between. And it really contributed to making me the person that I am today, because we always strive to acknowledge the fact that we were different. We always strive to acknowledge the fact that we had a diverse population in that town. And that's home. Like that's a lot of what we are, a lot of what we've always been. And I'm proud of that.
That's what's up. We live very close. Like it's I could get on a train and
well, let's
be there,
go, baby.
In like 2 hours.
Okay. So lunch, okay.
We could go to Bodega, get some,
I'm with
get
it.
Get some real quick.
I'm with it.
As long as they got good, good bread. Because last time I went to one, girl, I wanted to leave a Yelp review.
Always. And listen, I say it all the time. You want a real bagel? You want a really good New York bagel? You got to come to Long Island. People like saying Long Island not valid, but you got to come to Long Island if you want a really good bagel.
No, the Long Island. Okay, this is controversial. Okay. We're about to get controversial in here, y'all. Long Island has better pizza.
Mm-hmm. Tell them, baby. Tell them. Tell them.
Okay. I always wanted to go to New York. When I moved into the Boston area, I was like, you know, New York is a hop, skip, and a jump.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I could take the train and go to the bus to go to New York. And one of my friends says, you should go to Long Island. You should go see all the stuff over there and, you know, the coast and everything, right? So we made a 2-day trip out of it, right? Went to New York, and I'm like, I'm going to get me a slice. I'm going to try this. You know, my Italian roots was saying they got to have good pizza. No, that was ass.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to Long Island. It was Staten Island. I think it was Staten Island. I don't even know where we're at. I was so confused where I was half the time. But we went and got bagels. We went and got pizza. And we went and had, bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel.
Okay.
Fresh bagel out the oven.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I missed that. Oh, it was just so good.
It sounds like it's time for another one. Make it happen.
And yes, I may or may not have went into the ocean and people told me not to go in the ocean.
Oh my goodness.
But I'm alive. I'm just letting you know that it has been my goal to, you know, stick my feet, you know, maybe dip my toe in to every body of water that's around the world. But
but we ain't touching no Hudson. Gotta stay away from the Hudson. We don't do that.
It's okay. I'm still alive. My foot ain't fall off yet.
Oh my God.
I did grow a second pinky toe, but you know, it's all good. It's all good. I needed an extra one for balance.
Oh my goodness.
No, but I saw a fish and I swear that thing had 8 eyes. But anyway, I was like, that fish got 8 eyes. Am I tripping? We ain't gonna talk about it. This is one that I like to ask people. What are some of your pet peeves? Your biggest pet peeve that you just can't freaking stand?
Easy. Number one, disrespect.
Ooh, yep.
I don't tolerate that shit. Sorry, I shouldn't be cussing.
No. Oh, by the way, y'all, this is an adult podcast. I did not do my disclaimer before that. We may say such words as shit, fuck, bitch, whatever. And maybe a C word might come out. I don't know, depending on how angry I get. But this is an adult podcast. We allow cussing on the channel. It is what it is.
Well, my biggest, to answer your question for sure, my biggest pet peeve is disrespect. I don't know if it's because, so I'll give you a little bit of background. So my mother is Dominican. My mother was born and raised in the Dominican Republic, came to New York when she was 18 and has been here ever since. My dad is African-American and his family hails from the South, talking about North South Carolina over there, and starting to spread a little bit West type thing. And I don't know if it's because of the culture coming from both backgrounds. I don't know if it's just how I was raised. I don't know if it's a New York thing, but I don't tolerate disrespect. It's my biggest, biggest pet peeve. And I honestly believe that this world would be better and this world could do better if you just treated each person with respect. You don't have to agree. You ain't got to like them. Just respect them. They're still a person. Biggest pet peeve, 100% disrespect.
My biggest pet peeve is people that say they like to communicate and be there, but really, when you reach out in a time of need, and it may not be that, you know, you're depressed or anything like that. It's just you want to talk to somebody, and you reach out to them, and they go, "Oh, I'm sorry, man, I can't pull up on you right today. You know, I got a lot going on," but yet you see them posting on Instagram, home watching Netflix. And you're like, damn, ain't that a bitch?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, what it boils down to me, my pet peeve is basically, it's respect, but it's more along the lines of common decency.
Like, don't say about it. Like, be about it.
Be
like,
about it.
Just be about it. Like, if you say you're going to do something, you say you're going to hold somebody down, hold them down.
100%.
Be loyal. Be loyal. Hold them down.
Oh, God. Same pet peeve. Like, it's the same pet peeve, but just a little different.
It makes sense, though. 100% makes sense.
The other thing that I like to do is, guys, this is for this podcast is about kick streamers, spotlighting them, giving them a chance to talk about things they want to talk about. I do want to talk about a little bit about life. You did say that you grew up in basically a multicultural area. When you were growing up, was there anything crazy that happened when you were growing up that just stuck in your mind and has kind of stuck with you in your adult life?
I don't want to call it race wars, but that's exactly what it was. Like, to come from a household, as I said, where my mother is Hispanic and you have my dad that's African-American and you see the cultural differences, but you see also a lot of the struggles and the similarities between the two. I was being taught and I was being raised to be respectful. I was being taught to acknowledge the fact that you respect your elders. You listen. You don't be so quick to react. Sometimes you have to just stop and just wait patiently for things to happen, and don't be so quick to just make assumptions. Like, you have to make sure that you're taking it a day at a time, a step at a time, and that you're being very attentive as to the information that you're receiving. So my parents made it their business to teach me all of that from both perspectives of these are the traditions and these are the practices that we've had in like a Hispanic culture, and this is what we've had in an African-American culture and stuff like that. And they managed to find a way to try to blend it to where I would be able to have parts of both. So I will never forget growing up, like, as multicultural as it was, there's a lot of Hispanic people, there's a lot of African-American people. And they, especially in high school, like a lot of this back and forth of you have all the African-American people versus all the Hispanic people and just drama and fighting and targeting and gangs this and that. And like, it was just so negative and so like, just, it infuriates me because I'm like, I'm stuck in the middle. Where am I supposed to go? Who am I supposed to side with? I have friends on both sides of this. I have friends that are in a situation to where now you are targeting each other and you look into me and I'm just sitting here with like a deer in headlights of, okay, but what do I do? Because I understand where both of y'all are coming from. I understand the perspective as to why you guys are approaching it from this position of, this is why I'm doing this, and this is why this is disrespectful to me as an African-American person. This is why I'm doing this. This is why it's disrespectful to me as a Hispanic person. With me, because I was able to understand that, I was able to be like, okay, you know what? I get where you're coming from. I'm not justifying why you guys are reacting the way that you are, but I get it. But it still put me in a position where I felt like I was stuck in the middle. I felt like I was backed into a corner. So that was the biggest thing that I definitely remember the most. That there was constantly this bickering, this back and forth, this targeting one another. And I'm just like, bro, we all came from the same place. Can y'all stop? Like, can y'all chill? Like, what is good? Like, if anything, you guys actually are able to relate a lot more than you think. And instead of y'all just shutting up and listening and trying to get to know one another, you're making it your business to just target each other instead and just try to act as if one is superior over the other. And I'm like, bro. So, yeah, that was definitely the top thing for sure.
It 100% agree with it. It's I've been in that perspective. So where I grew up, you had one side of the tracks was a different gang. The other side of the tracks was a different gang.
Mm-hmm.
And if you went to the right side, there was a different gang. And if you went to the mm-hmm. left side, there was a different gang. Mm-hmm. And I had friends on both sides, close friends, friends that I knew their aunties, their aunts, their moms, their dads. You know, I knew them because of the type of work that my mother did. I was around that. I shouldn't say it's unfortunate. I should say I'm fortunate. I'm fortunate to experience that and learn those lessons in life. It molded me into the person that I am. I do stay a little guarded, but I do. I always lead with my heart. Have I gotten in trouble because I lead with my heart? You know I have.
Yeah. Yep.
Which, having a bleeding heart, it sucks, but it's also a blessing. Mm-hmm. Speaking about values, my mother always told me, you open up the door, you say hello, you be cordial, you be nice. And if somebody does disrespect you, don't be afraid to stand your ground and tell them how you feel. And speaking on that, last week I got slapped in the face.
Oh my God.
I opened up a door for a female. I said, you can go first. And she said, excuse me, you don't think I can open the door for myself? And I said, no, I didn't say that. I just wanted to open the door for you. You had a lot in your hands. And she got angry and slapped me.
Oh my goodness.
Needless to say, I went into the office. I may have said some choice words. And then I said, you know what? Carmo, get an ass.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to talk about kick. We're going to talk about kick. Let's get on this shit. If y'all don't know Shakaababyy, Shakaababyy apparently has been adopted by Eddie. I thought that shit was hilarious. If you don't know, Shaka was trolling Eddie a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't expect Eddie to come in.
Listen, I did not. So my thing was, I've been crocheting since I was about 8, 9, 10 years old. I was a Girl Scout when I was a kid, and my mother was my troop leader. And she had did one of, because one of the badges that we had was a crafting badge. So she had brought in all the materials for us to learn how to crochet. And she started teaching us how to crochet, and it stuck with me. And I, like, over the years, like, throughout the years and everything, like, I would go back and forth. I'd make a hat here. I'd make a blanket. I'd make a scarf. But it was never anything, like, as intricate as what I do now. And I started making dolls a year ago. I picked it back up. I was like, yo, I want to do something different. I'm going to start making dolls. And I was like, I was talking to a fellow streamer, shout out to Rolex, because he's the one that gave me the idea. He's like, yo, why don't you make an Eddie doll? And I'm like, bro, that's actually sick. Like, what do you mean? And he's like, yo, like, it would actually be like, it's good for content, obviously. And then imagine if he sees it. So I'm like, bet, like, I'm gonna do it. So I ended up, it was the first doll that I had made to try to resemble anybody ever. And I had made, I had started it off stream, and then I continued it on stream and everything. And then I was like, you know what? It's Saturday morning. I don't typically stream on Saturday mornings, but I know that he does his weekly Saturday stream. So I was like, yo, I'm going to troll a little bit. I'm going to go live. I'm going to pull him up on my stream, and I'm going to work on this doll, because I did, in fact, have to, like, use, obviously, like, a video or a picture of him to reference to make the doll capture his likeness. And I pulled up his stream, and we sat there for a good while just chilling and just watching his stream, listening to music and just crocheting and just putting the hairs in. And the next thing I know, somebody comes in and they're just like, yo, like, Eddie needs to see this. I was like, well, then go tell him. And then somebody comments after and is like, oh, he's coming. I'm like, what you mean? What? Like, he's coming where? Like, what are you talking about? And next thing I know, my chat started getting flooded with people talking about the doll and everything. And then I had his stream pulled up, and I see that he's actually watching me. And I'm like, yo, do you like the shirt? Because again, us in this whole, like, kick streaming world, like, we have this running joke that Eddie does not own any clothing outside of black t-shirts, because that's all we ever see him wear is a black tee. He don't wear nothing else. So, of course, the doll that I made had to have a black tee on it. So I'm laughing. I'm trolling him like, yo, you like the black tee? And he's like, yo, I do. Like, it's hilarious. So I wasn't expecting him at all to pull up and to see it. Then he ends up dropping 100 gifted. I'm like, bro, like, you weren't even supposed to come in here to do all that. I just wanted you to see the doll. That was it. Like, that was the most fulfilling moment for me, was just knowing that he saw that doll. And just the smile on his face and being able to see the live reaction and everything. I'm like, bro, like, this is like top tier forever. And it was so funny, because I actually had gone back and I watched the clip from his stream, and he was messing. He was talking to Mikey, and he was messing with him. He was like, oh, have you ever doll made of you? have you ever had a doll made of you? And Mikey's like, no. And he's like, well, I have. And I'm like, go on, Eddie. Go ahead, baby. You had a doll made of you. You better talk about it. Like, yes, you did. Yes, you did. He's like, yo, I feel like that's a life milestone. I'm like, well, it is now. So it really made me happy, because at the end of the day, like, if it wouldn't be for, it wouldn't have been for this man and obviously everybody else, a part of the team, like you have Andrew, you have Pauly, like these three are the face of Kick at this point, putting in all this work. This platform wouldn't be what it is, and I wouldn't even have an opportunity to have a voice on it. So I'm grateful for sure.
Yeah, it's, I watched the clips, I watched the videos, and I was like, he would do that. Right? And then I really started to think about it. I was like, Eddie, wait, every picture I've ever seen of Eddie or video or anything.
Black tee.
He doesn't wear anything but a black tee. I don't think he owns anything else. I feel bad. Do I need to, do we need to do a GoFundMe for some different clothes?
I don't know. Listen, if he out here dropping 100 gifters like nothing, I don't think we do, but I just find saying, it.
Do we need to make a t-shirt with a little color on it? Like,
I'm not going to lie that if he pulled up and he wasn't wearing a black tee, I'd riot. I honestly would riot. Like, at this point, like, the black tee is a staple. Like, no, I don't want to see nothing else. It better be the black tee. So, it was funny because a friend of mine, one of my mods as well, like, we started calling him Eddie with the black tee. So I'm like, yo, from this moment on, that's it. He Eddie with the black tee, period.
That's what's up. And Eddie is a character.
Mm-hmm.
Love him or hate him, guys. He's a character. You know, just get over it. Kick is here to stay. Kick is the number one platform, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. From day one when I started this, I said it multiple times. I grew on Kick faster than I did on any other social media streaming platform in the first 2 months I was on it.
Yep.
It's facts. Also, we're talking about Kick today. How did you first discover your passion for streaming on Kick, and what motivated you to pursue it further?
So I started being someone that's been streaming for 3 years. I had heard about Kick back in like January. I had made my page. I had secured my name because I was on Twitch at the time. And I got to a point where I was like, yo, like, I actually want to try this out. Like, this is going to give me a new opportunity. It's a fresh start, something new. Let me just try it and see what happens. So I finally had my first stream in March. And I, at the time, like, since I started in March, it's been a roller coaster for me, because I came over, I started gaming, and the gaming was getting a little bit of traction, but not really. And then another person had suggested that I try the pools and hot tubs category, because he's like, listen, like, you're crocheting and you're actually crocheting bikini tops, because it was obviously, like, it's almost springtime at that time. And he's like, yo, like, why don't you actually model the bikini tops that you're making? And then you can sit there and crochet and make them while you're on stream. I'm like, you know, it's actually a good idea. And people were into it. Like, obviously, they get titties in as a part of the deal. But they were actually really, because they were like, yo, what are you doing? Like, what do you make? You're actually making that? Like, that's crazy. So I had started with that. And then I was still gaming here and there. And I had actually left in the end of May, beginning of June, because I had gone back to Twitch because I play World of Warcraft, and I'm a part of a community that was being featured for Pride Month in Juneteenth. So I was actually selected to be one of the streamers featured for World of Warcraft at that time. So I had left Kick, went back to Twitch for a month. July hit. And I was nowhere to be found on any social media at all, because just life was life in. And then when we get to August, we're 2 weeks into August, and then my husband had just started a new job. And I'm like, yo, like, I need to get back into streaming. Like, that's it. Like, I'm going back into streaming. I don't care if it's on Twitch. I don't care if it's on Kick. If it's both, like, I miss doing this. Like, I need to go back into the passion that I had, because this was always fun for me. It was also an outlet for me, because I have really bad anxiety, and this helps keep me busy. So I ended up coming back in August, and I've been on Kick exclusively for the most part since August.
And it's that in itself, from August up to now, in itself has been a roller coaster, because I started with gaming, and then I started with just chatting, and then I switched over, and now I was doing Fortnite, and I was doing World of Warcraft, and now I'm primarily crocheting. And I always have been a variety streamer, and I appreciate the variety, because the variety like tends to give people the opportunity to really get to know me and understand that I'm a variety person. I'm not just a one trick pony. So it's been up and down for sure, but I can admit that my experience on Kick has allowed for me to actually find my passion the way that I originally had it when I first started streaming 3 years ago. I loved what I was doing. I had a purpose as to why I was doing it when I first started 3 years ago. And that was that I just wanted people to have a safe space. I wanted people to feel like they had a home to go to, a home outside of home. Because I know what it feels like to struggle with mental health and to not really have people to talk to or to that are willing to actually go the extra mile of just listening and being there for you and supporting you. So it's like, you know what? If I can create that for people, then it's a win for me. And being back on Kick since August, I found that again. And I'm here to stay for sure.
That's the main thing with me as well. I'm gonna be real. I was burnt out over on Twitch. I would always go on to stream. My main goal with streaming was to just to be somebody's smile, to give them a little bit of light, even though I may not be in the best mental state. I may not be okay. I still want to make sure that other people are okay. Recent events that I can really talk about. My best friend lost his partner to suicide. I'm an advocate for suicide prevention, as well as not being afraid to know that you don't have to be okay. It's okay to not be okay. There are so many things out there in this world to be thankful for. There are so many things to be grateful for, and I just want to create a space where people can come, vibe, and have a good time. I hope that I've created that on Kick. I know we all have our messy moments. Sometimes we get a little messy. And that was my main goal is coming over to Kick, is just having a place where people could come, vibe, be their true authentic selves, get away from their, you know, what's going on in life. Because life is lifing. Life's on a lot of people right now, especially around the holidays. It's hit me hard. I'm gonna be real. I'm gonna keep it 100. Being somebody that's going to school for mental health and going to get my degree and become a psychologist, I can't advocate for it enough. If there is somebody that you feel comfortable having a conversation with, hell, reach out to me. If you have a best friend, reach out to him. Hey, yo, I'm not doing good now. Can you just spend a day with me? That makes the world of a difference. Be there for your friends. Be authentic and be true to who you are. Shaka is one of those people. I know, like I said, not to Debbie down the stream a little, but here, Debbie down, what are we doing? I was having a bad day. I was having a very bad day. I went into your stream, wasn't thinking nothing of it. I was like, oh, I'm gonna check this person out. I don't know who they are or whatever. We're just gonna check them out. I went in there and I'm like, why am I smiling? Why am I laughing? Oh shit, I actually feel better. Wait, what did this happen? What pill did I take that I didn't know I took? But those are basically what I'm trying to get at is there's a lot of negativity on the app. There's a lot of negativity on any app you go to, okay?
It's the internet. Like, what do you expect? It's the internet.
It's the internet. You're going to see it, but there are genuine people. And that's the people I like to surround myself with, is people that are genuine and not putting on a fake face for the camera. Shaka has never done that. And I will speak on it. They have never fucking done that. Period.
Thank you.
Have you had your moments where you had to put a motherfucker down?
Mm-hmm.
I lost count the last 3 years, baby. Yes, I have. And I stand 10 toes down on that I do it again. I do it again. Don't come for me. I do it again. But at the end of the day, like I tell people exactly what you said. As long as you're making it your business to be the most authentic you, I'm going to support you. Like I was talking about this yesterday. Like, we ain't got to like each other. I don't need you to like me. But you're going to best believe that you're going to respect me. And the reason why you're going to respect me is because I respect you. And I'm always going to make it known that I respect you. I don't have to like you, but I'm still going to acknowledge you and respect you for the human that you are. I'm not here to be for everybody, and you're not here to be for everybody, and that's okay. That is fine. Y'all need to understand that for real. You do not have to be in this world to please other people. You have to be in this world to please yourself. That is priority. And as long as you're doing that, as long as you keep it in 100 with you, as long as you're proud of the moves that you're making for you, everything will flow into place and the people will follow. The like-minded people that genuinely see that and that support that and understand that you are doing nothing but just trying to be the best version of yourself, they don't love that. That's all I do is just be me.
I can't stress it enough. Just fucking be authentic, everyone, please.
Mm-hmm.
It puts a sour taste in my mouth when I see it.
Agreed.
It puts a sour taste in my mouth, and I just want people to you know, and I've said this from day one. There's people that aren't gonna fucking like me. I'm gonna be honest. Let's be mm-hmm. real. There's gonna be people that don't like me. You know, that's fine. I still respect you. I will still support you. And it's okay at the end of the day. Maybe you can actually open up yourself up a little bit, you know, and get to know me a little bit. And then you realize I'm not what people are saying. Because trust me, the DM I got yesterday. I was like, oh, really now? Oh, that's how they think of me. All right, cool. Let them think that. You want me to be that? Shit, I'll be that. Basically, we're going to talk about music here. I know my ADD is through the roof right now.
Oh, it's fine, baby.
We're going to talk about music. Now, I'm a DJ. Mm-hmm. And what is the one song that you cannot get out of your head? I'll let you tell yours, and after that, I'm going to tell mine.
So, do you mean like mainstream music, or are you talking about like
anything?
Just me.
Music that is just stuck in your head right now.
Winter by Vivaldi.
Okay. Winter by Vivaldi. Okay. Mine is that stupid water song. Make me sweat. Make me water. Yeah. That song came on, you know, the Apple Pod thing with the speaker. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I listen to music when I'm, you know, cup knucking and kikiing around here. And that song came on. And then Usher came on right after that. And I may or may not have accidentally thrown out my back. My boyfriend, he goes, hun, you know, it's been about 15 years since you was stripping, right? And I said, yeah. And he goes, you need an ice pack? Yeah.
I mean, I got some Bengay over here. You want me to give it to you? I got Bengay.
Girl, I just tell you this right now. Fuck my back out. Am I this old?
Oh. Yeah.
I was like, ooh, the lower back. Hold on. Why you back? Don't give out on me now. It was funny. I was being a Tatiana. Let's just be honest. I was living my days of, you know, watching. Oh, but this is another story. You're going to laugh at this one. You remember when they came out with those dollar coins?
Yes.
So I was stripping, right?
Okay.
I was making my money. I had go-goed 2 hours before, went to the other club, which was it was a gay club, and they allowed you to strip. Now, you could strip down all the way to your birthday suit if you wanted to. I didn't have to do that. I wasn't desperate like that. But we had a lot of older clientele that would come in. And I was dancing. I'm like, what just hit me? And I feel something else hit me. And I'm like, what the heck is that? I had this old lady in the front row throwing Sacagawea dollars at me.
Oh, my goodness.
I had rolls. And mind you, I didn't know how many dollars were in those. I was like, what are these roll of quarters? Why is somebody throwing a roll of quarters at me? And I didn't realize it's $20 per roll. I had like 15 of them up there. She was throwing rolls. I've heard about, you know, dropping ones on somebody or throwing a band on somebody. No, she was dropping rolls a quarter, rolls of dollars on me.
That is too funny. Oh, my goodness.
You can't make this shit up. The stuff that I've been through in life, I look back on and I'm like, damn, I survived that. Basically, this is another thing is I want to do is I want to give you your flowers. A lot of people don't understand what this analogy means. What this analogy means to me is a lot of people aren't given their flowers. A lot of people aren't given their grace. A lot of people aren't given their respect and their props in life. Unfortunately, until they're buried or put to rest. And I believe in giving people their flowers before they're gone. Telling them that they are somebody. Telling them that they are loved and respected. So I want to give you your flowers and let you know that you are cool, auntie.
Thank you.
We love you. Know that you are loved. Know that you are respected. And whatever fuck shit comes the way, trust me and believe I will be there to help and support. And if I gotta, you know, if I gotta pay for a lawyer, honey, I got you.
Will.
You need some bail money, I got you.
Listen, I let everybody know off the rip, baby. I'm from New York, so I'm with the shits.
I would like to share a little bit of a moment with you. When you were streaming, what challenges did you face? And how did you, as Shaka, overcome them and diversify who you are in streaming?
Oh, my goodness. Baby, where do I start? So being because you look at me and obviously I tend to be more female presenting. So being I started this journey as a bisexual black woman, bisexual Latinx woman. Well, Latino, I should say. And That's where everybody would see me. I was often looked at differently because obviously I'm a person of color that's currently in this streaming world where and in gaming where ultimately the majority and the demographic has most likely will always continue to be mainly geared towards attracting white men. Like that's just how it is always been. And it put me in a position where I would be often looked at because of that. I would be disrespected because of that. Called every name you can think of. I would be very sexualized. And it had nothing to do with what I was saying or what I was doing, what I was wearing, anything like that. Being degraded as a woman, everything that you could honestly think of, like it's happened to me. Like that's and it definitely got to me. I would clap back a lot when I first started streaming 3 years ago because I was like, you know what? I'm not tolerating that shit. Like y'all found the right one at this point. I'm gonna say something because I've always had a big mouth. I've always been very vocal about things. But it put me in a position where here I am 3 years later, and sometimes I'll clap back depending on the severity of it. Other times I just don't even bother. And it's not that I don't want to make a difference. It's not that I've fallen quiet of just not wanting to respond to it anymore. and not caring about it anymore, because obviously I care. Like, again, I still got a big ass mouth. It's more so that I've been on this journey within myself that I really acknowledge that sometimes these people, these trolls on the internet, are not worth the time. They're not worth the energy. They're not worth the arguing. Because at the end of the day, any single time that I argue, all anyone is going to see is me confirming that perpetuated stereotype of, here's another angry Black woman. That's all you are. That's all you're ever going to be. So I'll respond and I'll call people out on certain things. Other things, I'll just leave it be and just not even bother, and I'll just rise above. And it's working out for me, but I can't deny that even to this day, like, I'm still, I had it happen in my chat yesterday. I had literally people coming up, following me with the most reckless names that you can think of. And I'm like, bro, like, just comment in the chat so I can ban you. Just say something so I can ban you. Cause I'm not going to entertain it anymore. Like, at this point, it's old news. And the fact of the matter is that, yes, it's still relevant. Yes, it's still happening. Yes, it needs to stop. Yes, it needs to be addressed that this does happen every single day. And women are targeted more in this industry when it comes to being hated and being degraded. Women of color are targeted even more than that. And we're the lowest of the low on the totem pole in life, in this streamer world. And it sucks. So I've had to learn to build a thick skin and to just really not give a fuck. Like, I'm like, bro, like, at the end of the day, I'ma keep making my money, I'ma keep streaming, I'ma keep doing what I'm doing, I'ma keep vibing and shaking my ass, I'ma keep growing this community and finding people that see me for me and respect me for me, and I'ma keep it pushing. And again, as I said, I stand by it. I'm not for everybody, and if I'm not for them, that's perfectly fine, but they can go handle that shit outside of my space. That's how I see it.
It, basically, believing in yourself is key. And when we first start streaming, we really don't. I feel that we kind of have a discovery phase. We discover what works, we discover what don't work, and we also mm-hmm. discover who we are as a person. Even mm-hmm. though we're 100% authentic in ourselves, we really don't know what we're about yet. We don't know what we want to bring to the table. And you acknowledging that is 100% of the battle with whenever I worked with content creators, help them with their platform, help them with their branding. If they don't know who they are, you're creating a brand that doesn't mean nothing. You've actually created the brand as yourself to be your authentic self 100% of the time, regardless of what people think. And that's why I applaud you. We talked a little bit about it earlier. I do readings for people. And I did do a reading for you, if you would accept it.
What you got for me, baby?
I like to do these readings afterwards. The reading that I did for you today is, I do basic card readings, basically either deck, what it is. I actually grab a normal playing deck. Okay. Normal playing deck of cards. Each one of those cards has an individual meaning, individual value. What I pulled today was the Four of Hearts, which means you are stable, secure, and committed in your relationship or marriage. Also, I pulled the Seven of Hearts. It's a lot of heart cards today, which was weird. A partner or friend wants to basically connect to you and let them know that they are very important in your lives. The last one that I did, which is a little bit of a crazy one, was an ace, which is for new beginnings. There's new things on the horizon. That's basically a three card pull.
I love it.
Well, good things. You didn't get any bad cards, which is good.
You wanna why, baby? I'm divinely protected.
And I did throw one card did get thrown out, it flew at me. Mm-hmm. Which was the Two of Diamonds. The Two of Diamonds means that you are, there's good news and financial investments that are coming to you. Whether financial investments are time, money, or friends. Basically, everyone that's here, thank you so much for staying here, rocking with me and Shaka. I know that there will definitely be a part two down the line. I do like to do two-part series with people just to catch up, make sure they're doing okay. My main thing is we're going to do two more questions and we gonna end it, unfortunately.
That's fine with me, baby.
My last two questions.
Mm-hmm.
If you could give anybody any advice in life, what is the one thing you would give them?
Be yourself.
Period.
Always. Be yourself. Period. Always. And again, it's not about you pleasing anybody else. It don't matter if it's your mama, your daddy, your granddaddy, your grandpappy, your grandmama. It don't matter if it's your friends, your cousin, husband, your little girlfriend. I don't care who it is. Stop feeling like you owe anybody anything. And I'm not saying be ungrateful, because there's a difference, okay? There's a thin line between that, but there's a difference. There's a difference between being just blatantly ungrateful and acknowledging that you have to give yourself your flowers. You have to love yourself and give yourself the respect that you want others to give you. Put yourself on the pedestal that you want others to you want others to see you on. Don't wait for them to put you there. Put yourself there. That's number one. Like 100%. Like, be yourself. Love yourself.
100%. 100%. We got real deep in this shit.
We did.
She's good. I love having these deep conversations, and I hope y'all pop off in the comments down below. Also, make sure that you're sharing this, liking it, throwing it into the algorithm. I appreciate you guys just being your authentic selves, having fun, rocking with me on stream, rocking with Shaka, because I know you're probably going to be streaming later today. I think.
I will. Maybe. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. which I will be in there cupping up and kikiing. Just to let you guys know, this is an LGBTQIA podcast. If you do not like that we are part of the Rainbow Alphabet Mafia, the door's there. Like I said before, I ain't going to let you where the good Lord split you. Be blessed and have a good day. You can send the hate my way. It's okay. Don't send it at my people that I know out there, because trust me, those hate raids are real. I got called the N-word for the first time.
Ooh. How'd it feel?
I was like, I made it.
Get and baby, that's how you're supposed to feel. And then you're like, whoop, and I'm gonna keep it pushing.
What happened? I was like, did they not see my camera?
Mm-hmm.
They were telling me to go jump, go do all this stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I made it. I have become an official streamer.
Mm-hmm.
When you get a hate raid, you have made it.
Yep.
No, I like to put a negative into a positive. That's how I've always been in my life. I could have 18 things going wrong. I'm going to find that one positive. You always got to find that one positive. And if you guys haven't already known who's in the podcast right now, please go check out Shakaababyy over on Kick at kick.com. Shakaababyy. Also on all social medias as well. Also, don't be a creep and jump in their DMs, please.
I mean, unless you got a bag, by all means, but if you got a bag, let's go. Let's go. Come. I'm hungry. Feed me.
A friend of mine that I did about a year ago, they reached out to me and said somebody was in their DMs sending D-pics.
If they do that too, I expect to be paid for that. I charge.
I charge to view. But I just want to say thank you so much for trusting me to have this podcast. I appreciate you 100%. Look forward for new episodes coming out, guys. This is your boy, AO Fuzz. I appreciate you. Be well. Be blessed. Don't stress. And when in doubt, twerk it on out. Love y'all. We will see you in the next podcast. Until next time. Bye.
Bye.